Good morning everyone. Up to now we have studied how to change reported speech, how to change pronoun, how to change verb, how to change extra, and in the last video we have talked about simple sentences and interrogative sentences. So today I would like to talk about third one, that is imperative sentences. If imperative sentences will be given in the reported speech, then how can you change into indirect speech? First rule is reported speech. As I have told you earlier, reported speech will be same in all types of sentences, whether is imperative, whether is interrogative, simple, optative, or so on. Why I am repeating same thing again and again? Because in America, they are saying that repetition is must. Listening is must. So if you repeat something again and again, if you listen something again and again, then you will remember for sure without reading even. The reporting verb in the indirect speech, that is based on according to reported speech. Let me repeat. In imperative sentences, reporting verb will be on the basis of reported speech. It means if there is an order given in the reported speech, then accordingly you will write your reporting verb. If there is a request, if there is a suggestion, let's see such example of reporting verb. If there is an order, then our reporting verb will be order. If in a reported speech one is giving you an order, then the reporting verb will be order. If there is a command of something in the reported speech, I am talking about reported speech, sentence given in the inverted comma. If there is a command, our reporting verb will be commanded. If one is requesting to someone, then our reporting verb will be requested. If there is a suggestion, then suggested. If one is giving advice to someone, then our reporting verb will be advised. If one is giving instruction to someone, for example, teacher is giving instruction to students, then our reporting verb will be instructed. If one is asking to someone, our reporting verb will be ask. If somebody is telling, then told. If one is pleading to someone for something, then our reporting verb will be pleaded. And same time, if one is begging for something, then our reporting verb will be begged. Let me repeat again. Rules of reported speech will be same as I have talked about that earlier. Reporting verb will be based on reported speech. If you do not focus on this, your reporting verb will not be correct. So you need to see that which is given out of this, whether is order or instruction or request or suggestion or advice. On the basis of reported speech, whichever emotion or feeling given in the reported speech, we will write our reporting verb. Now next one is conjunction. Which conjunction we will take in imperative sentences? Here we will have two conjunctions. Two for positive sentences and not two for negative sentences. You need to check it out. Sentence is positive or sentence is negative. If positive, your conjunction will be to. If negative, your conjunction will be not to. Where to put conjunction? I told you earlier, when there is a comma. In the place of comma, you need to put conjunction for positive to and for negative not to. And the most important thing, you need to remove please. If in the sentence such words are given, please, and that shows extra, that we will delete when you turn from direct to indirect. We will delete please, such kind of word. So, most important thing, all rules are same. Second, reporting verb on the basis of reported speech, like order, commanded, requested. And third thing, conjunction, two for positive, not two for negative. Let's turn towards our example first. The master say to the servant, get out. See, let me tell you where is reported speech. The sentence in reported, in the inverted comma, that is called reported speech. So here reported speech is very short one, get out. The master, that is reporter, say to, reporting verb, the servant, that is listener. So here let's see, sentence is positive or negative. Sentence is positive, so we will use conjunction to. So our answer will be, the master. Second, reporting verb on the basis of reported speech. When you say to someone get out, it shows you are giving order to someone. So your reporting verb will be order. The master order to the servant, and reporting verb will be to, because sentence is positive. Servant to get out. See how easy. In all the sentences, I am teaching you sentences wise, because if you know how to turn sentences into indirect speech, then and then only you can turn paragraph. So first of all, I will talk about sentences and that simple example in the form of sentences, and then I will give you rules of dialogues and conversation, and then we will go for paragraph last, after completing all the sentences. Let's have second example of imperative sentences. Second one, I said to him, please give me your book. Here I, reporter, say to, reporting verb, him, listener, and this is reported speech. Here see, please is given, so we will delete. Sentence is again positive, so a conjunction will be to. Let's write. Let's see which reporting verb is suitable here. Please give me your book. It means, please give me your book. It means one is requesting, please give me your book. So here we will take requested as a reporting verb. So I requested him. In the place of comma, to conjunction, why? Because sentence is positive. I requested him to give. Now me. I told you, me we will change according to speaker. So who is speaker here? I. So definitely I, then me will be. If here he, then him. If she, then her. But I, then me. Here my not possible. You have to use your common sense. Where is third and second person will be suitable? In the between of the sentence. If in the place of subject, we will see definitely first person. But in the middle, we have to see whether it's second person or third person. So give me your. Now as I told you, your you will change, you, your, yourself, according to listener. So here who is listener? Him means a boy. So here we will not write him, because sometimes you have to see according to your knowledge of common sense, second person or third person, when you speak, which one is suitable. So here, his will come, his book, full stop. See, keep in mind, if in the starting, then first person you need to write on the basis of speaker and listener. If in the middle, you will see on the basis of speaker and listener only, but second and third person will be in the middle. But first one on the basis of first person, again speaker and listener. Let's have third example. Here I have taken third sentence I have taken, you can see do not is given. It means sentence itself negative. So our conjunction will be not to, right? So let's see first reporting verb, what will be speaker and listener and reported speech. So our reported speech is, please do not drive the scooter very fast. It means one is giving advice to someone. So our reporting verb will be advised. So let's write, he advised me. Now again see conjunction not to, because negative. Negative do not is given. So sentence is negative. So advised me not to drive the scooter very fast. If you know how to turn sentences, then and then only you can turn paragraph. That's why I am taking first basic sentences, simple one, so you can go from simple to complex, or mean simple to difficult. Let's have last example of imperative sentences. See, the mother said to the children, don't go near the cage. See, what does this reported speech wants to convey? Don't go near the cage. It means mother is giving instruction to the children. So our reporting verb will be instructed. And mother is reporter. Say to is reporting verb. And children are listener. Reported speech. So let's write, the mother instructed the children. Reported speech is negative, so our conjunction will be not to go near the cage. Imperative sentences are easy than interrogative, simple or exclamatory, because here no subject will be given, directly verb will be given in the reported speech. So if a positive, write you to. If don't or doesn't negative, then write not to as a conjunction, nothing else. Now I am going to talk about exclamatory sentences. I have completed simple sentences, I have completed interrogative, and today I have talked about imperative sentences with some examples. Now fourth one I am taking, that is exclamatory sentences. As I told you, in all the sentences I will make you remember again and again that reported speech will be same or rules will be same. Second thing, here again reporting verb, again you need to find it out, what does reported speech want to say, so which meaning is given in reported speech. So on the basis of reported speech, we will write our reporting verb. See, these words are common, exclaim and with. These two words will be there in all the reporting verbs. Exclaim, E-X-C-L-A-I-M-E-D, exclaim with. And third one will be on the basis of reported speech. What is the meaning of that sentence given in the reported speech? Let's see first one. If in the reported speech there is happiness or something that is good, then we will write exclaim with delight. If one is having joy, then we will write exclaim with joy or joyfully. If one is angry, that is given in reported speech, then we will write exclaim with angrily. Keep in mind, exclaim with will be common in all the reporting verb. You need to write exclaim with. Backside one will be changed according to the meaning of the reported speech given in the sentence. If somebody is in a pain, feeling sad, then we will write exclaim with sorrow. If one is feeling disgusting feeling, then we will write that something is disgusting, so exclaim with disgust. If one is feeling wonderful, then exclaim with wonder. If somebody is having surprise, we will write exclaim with surprise. And same time, if one is getting appreciation or one is praising to someone, we can write either appreciation or praise. That exclaim with appreciation or exclaim with praise. And conjunction will be that. In simple sentences, conjunction was that. And in exclamatory also, conjunction will be that. That you have to remember. If you do not remember which conjunction and which reporting speech or verb in which kind of sentences, then your reporting speech can be wrong. So keep in mind, you need to remember rules of all the sentences and rules that are general. Keep in mind. Now, about exclamatory, in the sentences, oh, hooray, alas, as I have told you, if in the sentences, oh, hooray, alas, what, how, such words will be given in the reported speech if there is exclamatory sentence. So these words you need to delete from this sentence. In imperative, we have deleted please word. Here we have deleted such words when you turn from direct to indirect if reported speech in the exclamatory sentence. Now, you know that if you turn from exclamatory to simple, then you need to add very, really, indeed, such kind of word. So keep in mind, if such words are added, then you can make it simple sentence from exclamatory to simple. Now, the main twist is, in interrogative I have talked about, first you will turn into simple, then turn into indirect speech. So here also same rule will be applied. First, exclamatory sentences turn into simple and then turn into indirect speech. Keep in mind, first exclamatory sentence turn into simple, then turn into indirect speech. For example, what a beautiful bird. For example, what a beautiful bird it is, exclamatory mark. So first we will turn into simple. It is a beautiful bird, simple. Then we will turn into indirect speech. It was a beautiful bird. That way we will do. Let's have some example of exclamatory. First one, the coolie said, what a heavy bag this is. Let's see what is given in the reported speech. What a heavy bag this is. So here we will see what can be. So here surprise is given. So as a reporting verb, we will see that our reporting verb will be exclaim with surprise. Let's write, reporter is the coolie. Coolie exclaim with surprise. You need to write exclaim with surprise. Whole reporting verb. Exclaim with surprise in the place of comma conjunction. What is the conjunction of in exclamatory? That. Exclaim with surprise that. Now main turning point. Turn into simple, then turn into indirect speech. What a heavy bag this is. So simple is, this is a heavy bag. Keep in mind, you can use pencil for making it simple, then you can rub when you turn that simple into indirect speech. So after that, let's turn that sentence into indirect. This, then again that, you need to write two times that. One that as a conjunction and second that because this is given. Is, then was, that was a heavy bag. See, if you go word by word, then your answer will be correct. Second example, The farmer said to the jackal, "What a selfish animal you are." See, here, what a selfish animal you are. Here, which reporting verb will be suitable? Because he is selfish, so maybe disgust possible or any feeling that you see possible. So, the farmer said to, which reporting verb? As I told you, exclaim with disgust. So, the farmer exclaimed, go word by word, so no problem. First we have written reporter, then say to that reporting verb. So I told you exclaim with disgust. Then listener, hear. Two you need to write before listener, because exclaim with disgust, that reporting verb we have written. Keep in mind, two you need to write before the listener in all exclamatory sentences. Except exclamatory, we will not write to in any sentences before listener. Only and only in exclamatory we will write to before the listener. Disgust to the jackal, conjunction will be that. Now let's turn into simple. What a selfish animal you are. You are a very selfish animal. So you can write you are. So you as a subject, we will change according to pronoun. So you, then speaker, the farmer. So farmer is he. So we will write here, instead of you, he, are, then, was, then a selfish animal. That he was a selfish, or he, or it, we can write. Sorry, he cannot be possible. I told you, then on the basis of listener, I took as a speaker. So not possible, that is my mistake. You on the basis of listener. So here the jackal is animal. So here answer should be it, because animal then non-living thing. So we will take it. It was a selfish animal. Full stop. In interrogative and in exclamatory, keep in mind, turn into simple, then turn into indirect speech, then it is easy. Otherwise, from directly exclamatory to indirect, not possible. From direct interrogative to indirect, not possible. So keep in mind that you have to check. Third one, see, when school will reopen, we will have so many examples again. Again, I will explain on the board. I will invite you to solve. But because of that corona problem, I am going to give limited example. But I hope you are getting and you are trying and you are reading rules again and again, because reading is must. Third one. Darshan said, how sweetly Bhairavi sings. See, here I have taken how. In previous two example, I took what. So if article what will be there, no article, then how. So here A is not given because how. So let's write how sweetly Bhairavi sings. Means one is appreciating. So our reporting verb will be appreciation. So Darshan exclaimed with appreciation again. I told you two we need to write before listener, but here see, here listener not given, so no need to write. Darshan exclaimed with appreciation, conjunction that. Now turn into simple, how sweetly Bhairavi sings. So Bhairavi sings sweetly. Let's turn into indirect that. Bhairavi, now main verb given, so our reporting verb will be sang. If main verb, I told you past form. So Bhairavi sang sweetly. How simple, easy. Now first two I took of what, second I took of how, and third I have taken if such words are given. Alas, hooray, oh, After this word, there will be exclamatory mark and subject, verb and extra will be given. Here, no need to check it out. That let us turn into simple and then turn into indirect speech. Here, directly subject, verb and extra in a sequence given. If such words, alas, hooray, oh. So, let's turn. Rupa. Here, see the reporting verb. We have missed the bus. Alas. It means they are feeling in a pain. They are in a sorrow. So, Rupa exclaimed with sorrow to, I told you two, you need to write before listener, to Krupa that, alas, such words I told I need to delete. We is a pronoun. So, we then, they, because plural, verb have then had missed the bus. Keep in mind whether is interrogative, exclamatory, simple or any kind of sentences. If you go in the sequence, speaker, reporting verb, listener, comma, conjunction, subject, pronoun, verb, extra, whatever. When you go in a sequence, you will clearly remember that what is the rule of pronoun, what is the rule of verb, what is the rule of reporting verb, what is the rule of extra, and which kind of sentences. That also you will keep in mind, nothing else. I hope you have understood four sentences, that is, first I completed simple, second interrogative, third imperative, and fourth, today I have completed exclamatory. Now, only few points are left, then I will talk about how to turn paragraph, that is, from direct to indirect. And that some rules are there that I will tell you. Till that, you copy down rules of imperative and that worksheet example and rules of exclamatory and that worksheet example. Then I will talk about in the next video again something new. All the best. Thank you.